Hello, ladies and gentlemen. My name is Arewa. I welcome you to History with Arewa. So this is just going to be a very quick one. There's a particular post going around for quite some few days now, and it's by the Oyos. I just keep getting tagged every day concerning it, and I think it is high time I just want to put the explanation out once and for all before it gets out of hand. So the Oyos are laying claim, saying that historical power of Alaafin, that the establishment of the new Ile-Ife by the Alaafin. The post is talking about after several years of the destruction. I'm reading destruction of Ile-Ife before the year 1870 AD, and their people became refugees of war at a neighboring town, village then known as Okeigbo, near Ondo, present day, and that there was no place to call Ife due to all the whole that it was destroyed, that is, Ile-Ife was destroyed completely. That was what the post is talking about. And so this made the king of Oyo at that time, Alaafin Adelu is the son of Alaafin Atiba, to instruct his Arekankan of Yoruba land, Bashorun Ogunmola. Bashorun Ogunmola was never Kankanfo. Oluyole was never Kankanfo. Let's move on. Instructed Bashorun Ogunmola to move Ife people that were in Okeigbo and resettle them in the new area that people are calling Ile-Ife, living presently. That this was between the year 1870, was the beginning of the new Ife as a new king, Ooni Orayegba Ojada the First, popularly known as Ayikiti, was ordered by Alaafin Adelu to be installed by the Bashorun Ogunmola. That is, they are trying to claim that Alaafin Adelu, that is, imposed Ayikiti, that is, Ibadan, imposed an Ooni on the Ife people. To say the least, this post is, I don't know what the Oyos are trying to get at this particular post. First off, they are claiming that Aikiti comes from, Ibadan, which is a big fallacy. Aikiti is an Ile-Ife man. Omo Ile-Ife is a prince of Ile-Ife, a Sooko of Ile-Ife. By Sooko, I mean prince. Ile-Ife princes are mostly called Sooko, while the Oyos, they call them, I mean, their own Akeyo. This is a very pure fabricated lies. Again, Ile-Ife has never been completely destroyed. Never, ever. There was never a time in history that Ife was at Okeigbo. It was Dẹ́rìn Ọlọ́gbẹ́nlá that established Okeigbo. And Dẹ́rìn Ọlọ́gbẹ́nlá himself is a prince of Ile-Ife. He lived there and became Ooni elect, but he refused to come to Ife to be crowned on time. He was the one on throne during the Kiriji War at Ile-Ife. The Kiriji War started between the year 1870 to 1886. That is the Kiriji War, which Fabunmi and Arimoro was, both of them were solidly on ground at Ile-Ife, defending the sacred cradle of Yorubas. Even the women were moved to Isoya, away from the raging confrontation. Dẹ́rìn Ọlọ́gbẹ́nlá himself, he was a combatant, he was held at he was at Okeigbo. He survived this particular war. And he is the one that signed the erotic this Yoruba priest, I mean peace treaty, executed at Kirigilmessing battlefield, along with other Obas on the 23rd September 1886. Even the famous Samuel Johnson book that the Oyos are quickly, that they quickly quote, wrote, Samuel Johnson is a Yoruba man. The book he wrote, The History of the Yoruba, he said, and I quote, he talked about, recorded how the Alaafin sent emissaries to the Ooni Dẹ́rìn Ọlọ́gbẹ́nlá with gifts, pleading with the Ooni to make him stop the war. Samuel Johnson wrote that in his book, he's an Oyo man. Now, what the Oyos don't know about it, see, let's talk about Ayikiti. Ayikiti was an Ife prince, but he was living at Ibadan. Ongonwa ninu omo jagun jagun is a military, he's in the military. He's an Ife prince, staying based at Ibadan. Omo ile Ife ni is a prince, it's Oko of Ife, but he stays at Ibadan. And he's also into military. So he solicited for the military backing of Ibadan to help him become the Oni, you know, to a great level, past all the other competitions. Because he was in the army, you know, so he solicited for the help of the army to help him become the Oni. But he is an Ile Ife prince. Omo Ife ni, shugbon ongbe ni Ibadan. Ongo wa ninu awon ogun awon ton jagun jagun o wa ninu military ni Ibadan omo ile Ife ni ti o ngbe ni Ibadan because even by then the Oyos as at then was under the power of Ibadan. Yes, there's something about the power of Yoruba land that we don't normally talk about. There is no time in history that the power of Yoruba land stays in one place for life. Kosinko konton jebe. It moved constantly within. The Oyo were not the first to hold power, and they were not the last that held the power. Ibadan was the last that held power. Ibadan lolu agbara last. There was a time the first is the Owus, awon Owu lagbara ile Yoruba wa lowo tele. Ko to kuro. Ko te to lalapo won fe de Oyo, kon to lalapo won fe bi en ton pe ni orun miyan. So, the power of Yoruba land has never stayed in one place for life. It moves. Oma move, Ukirene. Ibadan held power last. Even as at then, the Oyos were under the power of Ibadan. Because Ibadan lo lu agbara, lo mu agbara, dani ni Ibanye. And Bashorun Ogunmola was never a kankan for. And Ogunmola was not under any influence of Alaafin. Because, but he is a warrior hala. Adelu solicited for the help of Oluyole in fighting of Kurumi at Ijaye, as well as Oluyole at Ibadan. If you remember that war, Ile Ife was never destroyed. It was abandoned halfway, and a new town was established called Isoya for like 15 years. It is still existing till date. And that was the new Ife. And it was established by the Ife themselves, not by any Alaafin. Ogunmola came to beg the Ifes at Isoya to return home. He did not establish any Ife at all, at all. Ife has been where Ife is since the very day of Oduduwa himself. And there was no a time that it was destroyed completely. No. When the Ife returned home, they were not building new homes. They returned to their standing accordies. One pada. Deserted. No. It was not destroyed. No, no, no. Ogunmola went to beg them at his Isoya to come back home. He did not find a new Ife for them. Ogunmola himself gone was a babalawo. And he realized that the land is a great, there's going to be the Ile Yoruba oni settle. Nitori pe gbogbo awon Ife won ti kuro ni bi ta won deities won wa. Because anybody to nbo deities, which is a very grave, you know, incident. So he had to go and beg them back because of that. Again, also, Samuel Johnson also wrote in his book that Ogunmola said it is not good. I'm quoting it. It is not good for the source of a tribe to be abandoned. So he went begging them to return and rejoin the others remaining at home. Ogunmola himself did not see Adelu as his king, but as a valley lord that he is. And when he wanted, they said when Ogunmola wanted to build his house, he sent messages to Allah Afin Atoyo that he should provide some posts for his bank colleague. He did. So Ife was not re-established. Ife has been where Ife is since the day of Odudua till present, and Isoya is still there as the new Ife. So all these are just fabricated lies. More so, Ayikiti did not reign that long on throne, as I normally try to say. And his name was pronounced as Orarigba, he who manages to take. He was only staying at Ibadan as an Ibadan soldier. He's an Ile-Ife prince. Just like Olugbode, Baale Olugbode of Ibadan, who stayed somewhere away, some poles away from Labinran, but he's from Owukuta. Just like Ibikunle, who came from Ijado in Iresa. But all of them stayed, just like Ogedengbe, who returned to Ilesha to become the warlord and the Obanla. Just like Fabumi Okemesi, who was once an Ibadan soldier but later went back to Owaoye of Imesi. I'm making an example. So Ayikiti is a complete Ife man from Gayesin ruling house, and he is not an Ibadan man, contrary to whatever the Oyos are trying to project these days. Ayikiti is a complete Ile-Ife man, a prince of Ile-Ife. He was only residing in Ibadan. So, Ayikiti is not an Ibadan indiji. No, he's an Ile-Ife indiji. He just stayed at Ibadan. And once again, the post, you know, it's like that he spent from which year to which year. He even got the years wrong to start with. Secondly, Ayikiti did not stay even more than, he did not even stay up to a year on throne in Ife. The Ifes poisoned him because they didn't see him to be their king. They did go on rituals. All the rituals, all the rites and rituals that they are supposed to do, they did not do any for him because he wants to okay, you want to be a king by force. Okay, now sit down there and be ruling. Gbogbo awon eto ti o ye ki won se fun won se awon agba Ife o se o ko force are wa nbe ni. Won de poison ni eni ko lo to osu mefa go on throne. Won poison eni tori won ri bi oba. Ko wo pe bi gbogbo nkan to ye kan se ko se itan se fun tori won ri gege bi oba won ni. Won de poison ni to ku ko lo to osu mefa lori ipo. I've said it times without number that there's something about Ile-Ife that people don't get. See, Ife is a nation. To wa ni ilu is a nation. Just example, let me give an example. Just as Abeokuta, Ibadan, Ekiti, Ondo, you know, ki gbogbo wa kora wa papo. Ka wa form nation. Ka wa so nation wa yen ni oruko kan bo. Ko ni kaloku ma jo oruko to fe je ni under. Ta ba de nation wo ni kaloku mo ile e to fe gba lo, ilu e to fe gba lo. That is what happens. If there is a nation to ni about 16 towns, to je ilu, ta won ni oba, ta won na tun ni capital titi won. Ta won na tin ni oba, won ton tun ni bale, ton tin ni gbogbo e. So if there is a nation, that is one mistake ta ma make. Secondly, another mistake Oyo people normally make is that Oyo won mo itan titi won. Oyo don't know the story, the history of Ife. Oyo don't even know the history of Odudua. Oyo don't even know the history of this Oromiyan that they are claiming to be descendant of. They don't know. The only thing that they know about Oromiyan is he gave back to Ajaka, Tela, and Owomika. The rest of his children, they don't know. Oromiyan has seven sons, seven good sons, and plenty female daughters. The Oyos, they don't know Kokon won mo. Odudua won mo itan Odudua. Gbogbo many di logo agbagba many di lungu to wa ni Ile-Ife Oyo don't know their history. They don't know. So ohun ni confusion yen ni o se ni ko se nyi awon Ile-Ife awon Oyo. Oyo never went to Ile-Ife to ask to proper get history, their research history. They never did. They don't do that. iyan ko o le dajoba nife ele lati mu eleyi wa kele mu eleyi wa kele mu ele wa no ma papo so ohun lo se je wi pe gbogbo awon agbagba 16 lati panupo ton ma mu eyan to fe fi joba ni to ba lo se pe o fe lo juwa nbe ko fe joba by force won ni bedun joko sibe ti won ba pa e won ko ma hun erun tori gbogbo eto to yen kan se won ni se gbogbo won ni se anything fun e wa ko wa nbe ni ma ru lare nitori pe ife ile ife wa ule ife wa ile ife wa ile ife wa ile ati ile ile ife ile ife wa so meji ni won ni se kokan fun e to ba lo tan oruko e ko ni wa on record pe ojoba nbe ri tori won o kin se oba won ni kai kun oba won. That is one thing about Ile-Ife that people, in fact, if they say we should count the kings that have ruled after from Odudua downwards, it's almost 100. But this our present on just the 51st. Ile-Ife people will not write your name. Oruko ni wo we to ba lo. Ton ba poison e ton ba pa e. Won ko ma wo eran ni. Ti o ba de lo ton won ni koruko e si we po joba nberi. That is one thing about Ile-Ife. Ti awon eyan ti get dada. And that Ile-Ife to ba tu fe lo gba ton ni fe. Awon to wa ni deta itan won ni won mo awon to wa ni loromu awon yen mo ti won to ba lo si deta ko fe lo ma gba itan awon iloromu ko si bo se fe gba o lati lo si gbogbo e lo gba ni. That is another mistake ti awon eyan tun ma nse ton ba na awon fe ma research nipa history ife. Many people know their history but none invested in researching about Ile-Ife history as a whole. They never did. Ojudua history is different from Yoruba history. Ko sin kokan to kan ojuju apelu pe Yoruba o no Yoruba. We are mixing it together. So there is never a time that Ile-Ife was distracted. Ko sin kokan ti o nje be. Yes, Modakeke and Ife have always been at war within each other. Fine. Ayikiti is an Ile-Ife man. He's a prince of Ile-Ife. He resides as Ibadan. Omo Ile-Ife ni. Ko kin se pe boya won wa impose omo Ibadan le wo lori nife. No, no, no. Omo Ile-Ife ni. Sugbon n gbe ni Ibadan ohun na de wa ninu ologun ohun lo se fe lo style lati lo backing ologun wole lati fi joba. So gbogbo oro tawon eyan so yen ko si nkankan ti o je be omo Ile-Ife ni Ayikiti ko n se omo Ibadan o gbe ni Ibadan ni ko n so omo Ibadan Ile-Ife ni won bi si o ko gbe ni Ibadan ni. So I don't know whatever the Oyos are trying to be claiming with this sudden history. I don't understand. Or you're struggling. They are struggling. Your empire has come and go. Can we just stop all this? If you are claiming that you are because the on whose authority is Alaafin supposed to be the king of all the whole of Yoruba land? On whose authority? If it were to be empire, we'll say okay. If Oyo should be claiming that means Benin too we claim. Because Benin was an empire as well. The same person that founded this one founded this one. So if Alaafin wants to be claiming to be the head of everybody because it was once an empire, the Benin will also do that. They also have rights to do that. And if Ife never existed, there is nothing called Oyo. Ti Ife Oba exists, ko sin kokan ti o nje Oyo. Oran miyan never moved power abi ruling to Oyo. Next time, if Oyo people don't desert from all this, he is not a king. He is shekini kokinikan. The Odudua's children were not. He is not the bloodline of Odudua. Please let us reason this thing together. You, the same Odudua, or your people will claim that Odudua came, he fought, he met rulers down in Ife, he fought and became ruler. He met ruler down. Oja ogbagbara. Oje obale won lori. Oba yon be o. Oba oba nbe o. Oja ogba. Now. Ti oni ba wa ja na nisin yi to ba gbagbara lowo awon omo Ojudua o kin se is not the bloodline of Obatala. Ojudua was not even the bloodline of Obatala that was ruling in Ife. He wasn't. So he became king. So if oni now that is not the blood that you that whom you claimed alleged that is not the bloodline of Ojudua is ruling, it is still the same thing. Ojudua was never the bloodline of Obatala. So, Oni does not need to be the bloodline of Ojudua before he can rule. Who says that it is only Ojudua that is of royalty? If you accepted that there's a ruler in Ife, whom Ojudua is not a bloodline of, but he became king, Oni have the same right. He's not the bloodline of Ojudua, but he became king as well. So, case closed. Oduduwa did not found the throne at Ife. He did not. He met people there. He didn't start from him.